guys, it's Easter Films. As you saw, I have a new intro. I was going to make it stop motion, but I decided to make it that. I just felt like it looked a little bit better and cleaner. So, you know. And thank you guys so much for 270 subscribers. We're 30 away from 300, which is pretty awesome. Well, I would love to hit it by the end of August, if we can. Just anytime really is awesome. So today I'm going to be announcing the photo contest results, and we also have a guest judge. But who exactly is the guest judge? Well, the guest judge is AG Ovation. I am so excited to have our guest judging for you guys. And I plan on having another guest judge, I get off, some other time. It's just a lot of fun. And yeah.
Hi everyone, I'm AG Ovation, and I'm so honored to be guest judging for AG Star Films Photo Contest, Dolls Being Dolls.
I also want to tell you that I changed the name to AGNBS, which stands for American Girls Next Big Star. So if you end up winning, you're American Girls Next Big Star for like photos and all that, if you understand. So let's go ahead and get into picking, not picking, kind of showing you the results and what I think of your photos. So the theme was Dolls Being Dolls. So we're going to go ahead and get into the first photo, which is from the AG Boy. Remember to subscribe, like, and turn on the bell so you never miss a video. So let's go ahead and get into the AG Boy's photo. So this is their photo. It is stunning. I really like the style he did with this, where there's like one photo in the middle and then there's all these different photos. It is kind of distracting to the eye though. With all the photos, it's like, where exactly am I supposed to look? Kind of with the filter on the two photos that I'm circled on right now. It's a bit distracting because you can't exactly know what you're supposed to be looking at. Also, it doesn't quite fit the theme of Dolls Being Dolls, if you understand what I mean. But if this was a freestyle, it's really cool. The only thing is just distracting. The lighting is perfect. Her eyes are very clear. Overall, this photo is really awesome. It's just breathtaking. Overall, I give your photo a 9 out of 10 just because it doesn't match the theme and it is very distracting to the eye. Great job. Let's see AG Ovation's opinion on this photo.
The first photo comes from Nenea, and this is so adorable. I love the collage pictures and how many different editing attempts, not attempts, but like different editing styles that you put on this photo. It's really cute. I don't think it really screams the theme of Dolls Being Dolls, but it's still really adorable, and I give you a 9 out of 10 for this week.
I agree with AG Ovation, but now we're going to move on to Charlotte's picture. This one is so beautiful. I absolutely love that you're outside taking a picture of your doll. This definitely does represent Dolls Being Dolls, like, all the way. The lighting is very nice. It's so pretty, especially since it's outside. I like how you're holding the camera and taking a picture of the doll. One thing is, the doll's eyes are a bit dark. I would have liked if you maybe lightened that up a little bit, but overall, it's such an incredible photo. I give your photo a 10 out of 10. Great job!
Next, we have Charlotte, and this is absolutely adorable. I love, love, love all of everything that was put into this photo. I love how you're in the shot as well, taking a picture of her, because this definitely describes the doll photography life. I love the background. It's a little backlit, so I would just kind of even out the light everywhere. And I would write in a prize, but this is amazing. I give you a 10 out of 10.
Next up, we have AG Abby Forever. This one is so, so cute. I absolutely love that there's a little dollhouse. Like, oh my gosh, where did you get that from? And I love the little dolls. I like how she's playing with them. The thing is, the filter kind of makes it a little bit off-lighted. Like, it's a bit kind of, I don't know how to exactly describe it. It just kind of changes the photo a bit if you use, like, the story filter, if you know what that is. It would have been a little bit more of a pop. It kind of takes away the color from the photo with this filter. But overall, this photo is super cute. I love everything about it. Overall, I give your photo a 9 out of 10 just because, you know, the filter. But overall, it is so cute.
Next picture we have from Lucy, and I love how your doll is playing with other mini dolls in a little mini house. It's so, so adorable. The thing is, I imagine like dolls being dolls as your doll model being the doll, not having other dolls. But I still think it's really creative and really cool. The background's a little plain, but it's really cute, and I give you a 7 out of 10.
We have Stop Motion Times AG with her doll, Isla Jade. I absolutely love her name, by the way. So as you can see, she is in the human's bed sleeping. I love the face mask and the lights are super cute. It is kind of blurry. I can definitely see that YouTube possibly killed the quality as usual. I love the little koala as well. It is like I said, it's a bit fuzzy and maybe a different angle as well, so we can see a little bit more of the bed. Oops, sorry. Okay, but yeah, overall it's really cute. Your photo an 8 out of 10. Congratulations.
The next picture is from Isla Jade, and I love this picture so much. It's so adorable. I love the fairy lights on your bed, just like to say that first. It's so cute on how she has like pajamas, a little face mask, and a little stuffed animal. However, if I saw this picture, I would think dolls being humans rather than dolls being dolls, if you know what I'm saying. But overall, this is really cute, and I give you an 9 out of 10.
Up, we have Treo World's photo with her doll Isabel. So this photo is really interesting. So she said it was a 3-year-old playing with a doll. I would have liked to see maybe the 3-year-old actually playing with the doll. And so as you can see, she's kind of on the ground. It kind of doesn't show dolls being dolls. It kind of is a bit random into the theme. But the outfit is super cute overall. The lighting's quite nice actually. But yeah, I give your photo a 8 out of 10.
Next, we have the model Isabel, and I love this photo so much. I love how she's laying on the ground and how she's upside down and her limbs are in all different positions because you did say it was like a 4-year-old playing with her. I love her outfit. It's super, super cute. You did say it was like a 4-year-old playing with her. I wouldn't be able to guess that if I saw this picture, but it's still really cute, and I give you an 8 out of 10.
We have AG Dalmatian's photo with her doll Joss. This photo is so cute. I like how she's outside on a swing. One thing is, it is a bit blurry. Her outfit is super adorable, and her hair is so cute as well. Overall, I give your photo a 9 out of 10. Congratulations!
Next, we have a photo from Joss, and this is absolutely adorable. I love how she's on the swing, and I love her crazy outfit and the mismatched shoes, and her hair describes everything. I love how it's in all different positions because I definitely think that describes the theme, and I love how she's on a swing. The only thing I would say is you could brighten up her eyes just to make a little stand out a little more, and maybe either bring her closer to the camera or like blur out a little more of the background so you know that, she's the one. But overall, a great job, and I give you a 9 out of 10.
We have Dolly AG with her doll, Nania. This one represents dolls being dolls, like, exactly. I love your matching outfits. They're so cute. The lighting is perfect. I like how you blurred out the background. I just love everything about this photo. Overall, I give your photo a 10 out of 10. Congratulations.
The next picture we have from another Nenea, and this is absolutely adorable. I love the pool in the background and the greenery and how it's blurred out so you know where to look at, but your camera is still like really crisp and clear. I actually have that doll outfit for my doll and for myself, so that's kind of cool. I love how you're in the frame, and I love how she's there too, the doll. I think this definitely describes the theme. I would say maybe like put your arm around her or something. I don't know, but I give you a 10 out of 10.
We have Pixie Cutie Studios photo with their doll Holly. This one is really creative. I like how you edit them into the stream. It is such a nice landscape. I absolutely like how her hair is. Like, it looks so cool. It kind of looks like she's a little bit miniature as well. I wonder how you did that. I'm like, what? I like the filter she is in, but it doesn't really show dolls being dolls. I would have liked you to show that more into the photo if you understand that. Overall, I give your photo an 8 out of 10.
The next picture comes from Holly, and I think this is really cool. I love how you edited her into such a cool landscape, and her hair is really pretty. Great job. I don't really think it screams the theme of dolls being dolls. It just looks like a doll well edited into a nice landscape, so I would just make it a little more obvious what the theme was, because I don't think I would be able to guess it if I didn't know. Your overall score, well, my score for you, is going to be a 6 out of 10.
Next up, we have Delicious Donuts photo with their doll Kanani. This one is so, so adorable. I absolutely love that you're out in the rain and how you're holding your hand. And I love Kanani's raincoat, like, so adorable. Her hair is really nice. It looks very flawless. Overall, the photo is super cute. One thing is, it is kind of fuzzy a little bit where Kanani is, but still super adorable. Give your photo a 9 out of 10.
The next picture comes from, oh dear, Kanona? I don't know how to pronounce it. I'm really sorry. But this is really, really adorable. I love how you're bending down to, like, hold her hand. Her outfit is stunning, and so is yours. And I love her hair, and it's just all adorable. I would just make the background a little more interesting because it's just, like, white, but not too interesting that it takes it away from the photo, if you know what I mean. But overall, a great job, and I give you a 9 out of 10.
We have AGSM Productions with their doll, Isabel. This one represents it so well. I like how she's in, like, a toy bin, possibly. And with all the toys, it definitely shows dolls being dolls. The lighting is really nice. I like all the stuffed animals. You have quite a collection. And I like how her face is directly in the middle, so you know what you're staring at. I would have liked if you did blur out the stuffed animals a little bit more so you know exactly what you're supposed to stare at. But overall, it's a really cute photo, and I give your photo an 8 out of 10.
Next, we have another Isabel doll, and this is absolutely adorable. I love all of the stuffed animals around her. She's just kind of blending in, and I just love everything that you put into it. She's, like, in a toy bin, and she is a toy, so that works with the theme. So, good job. I feel like something's kind of missing because there are, like, it's, like, super busy, but something's also missing at the same time. It's kind of hard to understand and explain, but you still did a great job, and I'm going to give you an 8 out of 10.
The last photo we have here is Kitty Cat AG Stop Motions with their doll Grace. So here's this photo. I really like this photo. It's super cute. I like how with the remote kind of shows, like, where you lay your dolls usually, like, you probably lay them on your bed or something, or on the couch, you know, and it happens to be a remote right near her, so it's like she's watching TV or something. The couch is really cute, and I like the little throw pillows. Overall, one thing is her hair is a bit messy and it is a little bit fuzzy, so if you fixed that, that would have been awesome. I'll give your photo an 8 out of 10.
And the last photo comes from Grace, and this is absolutely adorable. I love how she has the remote in her hand, and she's just kind of chilling, maybe watching some TV. I love your couch and the pillow. It's so perfectly placed and everything. The only thing I would say is this kind of is like Isla Jade's photo. It's more like a doll's being humans, because this isn't really an activity a doll would normally do, if you know what I mean. You still did an amazing job, and I'm going to give you a 7 out of 10. Those are all of the photos for this week. Everyone did absolutely amazing, and I hope you didn't find me too harsh. It's really hard, but you all did so, so amazing. And now I'm going to hand it all over to AG Star Films to finish up with the judging and everything else. So, thank you so much to AG Star Films for having me guest judge, and great job to everyone else.
Thank you so much, AG Ovation, for guest judging for me. That was such a sweet thing for you to do. There was a lot of people, so I wasn't really expecting you to be able to do it. But wow, you were awesome. I loved your opinions on the photos, and I definitely agreed with a lot of them. You all also did an incredible job with the photos. I was mind blown with a lot of the photos. You guys are just crazy good. So there will be no eliminations due to someone having to drop out. So kind of sad about that. But happy because I don't have to eliminate anybody, because it's always a pain. So anyways, I'm going to go ahead and get into information for Cycle 2, Round 3. The due date is going to be July 24th because I want to give you guys a week, and by the time this is posted, which will be tomorrow, technically today for you guys, but yeah. And the theme is retro. I am so excited for this theme because I just think it's such a cool thing. If you don't understand the theme, I can definitely tell you in the comments below. Thank you guys so much for watching. You did an incredible job. And thank you once again to AG Ovation for guest judging. Please remember to subscribe, like, and turn on the bell so you never miss a video. Bye, guys!